It's a center for art by artists with disabilities, which has the larger art world paying major attention. Jeffrey Brown recently visited the San Francisco Bay Area for our ongoing look at health and the arts, part of our Canvas series.
A crowded exhibition at SF MoMA, the San Francisco Museum of Modern Art, known for showing works of leading contemporary artists. On display here, a large abstract painting by 43-year-old Joseph Aleph.
It's a big thing. It's a big accomplishment in my life. And to see a painting like this and to imagine how incredible I did, and it's wow. And it's just, I'll be amazing. It's just wow.
Also in the exhibition, Susan Jano.
You probably didn't expect that when you started 21 years ago.
Mm-mm.
No.
No. And here I am today doing exhibitions.
I can tell you it's totally amazing. In this,
Jano and Aleph are among some 140 self-taught artists who call Creative Growth Art Center in Oakland, California, their creative home.
It's really awesome.
The organization, celebrating its 50th year, offers an open, light-filled space, supplies, and instructors like Amy Kiefer.
So are these different kinds of cards or just different colors?
Camaraderie and all-around support to people with developmental, mental, and physical disabilities. Executive Director Tom DiMaria.
The idea of being an artist is often a privileged act. So I think if we bring people into an artistic studio and say, you can be creative here, we'll support you, you have materials, please tell us, you know, your story, please experiment, there's no right or wrong here. That's an incredible opportunity.
And you're saying these are people who often have been told the opposite.
Yes, these are people who have been told the opposite. And I think it's as simple as flipping the switch from, you know, I don't want to hear from you to I do want to hear from you. You can't contribute, you can be a major contributor. You're outside of culture, you're a cultural leader. And I think those are important ideas.
Founded in 1974 by Elias Katz and Florence Ludens Katz as part of a burgeoning disability rights movement, Creative Growth is one of three such organizations in the Bay Area alone. Not a therapy or health center, but a working art studio for people making a variety of kinds of art, including on this day, textiles for an upcoming annual fashion show. 59-year-old William Scott was using 3D modeling software to help plan his next painting. He has autism.
I should read a little.
And had prepared a statement for us.
I feel happiness because I am a peacemaker. I feel very proud of my big mirror in the museum SF MoMA.
Scott paints versions of himself, family members, and others. And alternative worlds. His 32-foot-long mural at the museum presents a reimagined San Francisco called Praise Frisco.
You're also looking at a different kind of city with no violence.
That's right.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
And how does the art let you do that?
Because the art makes a real world, making the real world.
The art makes the real world.
It does. It makes the real world. That's why it does that. That's why I do that.
The museum exhibition is titled Creative Growth, The House That Art Built, with 80 works by 11 artists, including intricately layered works on paper by Dwight McIntosh and Dan Miller, brightly colored paintings by Alice Wong and Ron Vesey, ceramics by John Martin. Susan Jano, who has an intellectual disability, works in a variety of media, including video. In this one, she stares at the camera while posing questions in voiceover.
When I first started going to Creative Growth, I found art and started drawing, and that was my calling.
Joseph Aleph, who has autism, paints most days at Creative Growth.
Going to Creative Growth, that's been a very important part of your life?
Yeah.
Why? Tell me, what do you get from it?
Just by going there and get my experience out in how I feel and just imagine in how I feel in my heart and in my soul and just paint.
Most striking now, the embrace of these artists by the mainstream art world, where a number of them, including William Scott, are in important collections and leading museums like SF MoMA, and earning money for their work. The museum, in fact, recently purchased more than 100 works by Creative Growth artists, and this exhibition is the start of a 3-year partnership. Katie Siegel is SF MoMA's research director. The hope for this first exhibition, she says,
just to blow people away, overwhelm them with the evidence that these artists are incredibly important. That said, going forward, I'm really most excited in a way about showing that art throughout the whole museum, putting it in the context of the larger collection and showing these artists just like all the other great artists making great artwork in our collection.
So the idea for now has to be an exhibition dedicated to disabled artists, but eventually integrated.
Yes. I think museums have done a lot of gatekeeping over the years around who's a professional artist. And so the idea of having self-trained artists, having artists with differing abilities, having artists from different backgrounds, and judging people not by their certifications, but by their artwork.
Back at Creative Growth Art Center, I asked Executive Director Tom DiMaria about this.
Are you asking people to come see this as the work of disabled artists?
Right.
Or are you asking them to come see the art?
Yes. So that's the critical question. Is this a disabled art exhibition, or is it an exhibition by artists who have disabilities? And we tend to lead with art, saying that, you know, if the art is interesting, that's why it's in the museum. But there is a very important lived experience of the artist's disability and the culture of disability that's within the work.
That's the advocacy part.
That's the advocacy part. And then once that's happened, you can say, okay, the work is on the wall, and we're in the art world, and now we have something to say.
The magnitude of the museum exhibition brought plenty of emotion, including tears, as well as the support people told us they feel among a community of friends. It all culminated, as every Friday afternoon, with a dance party. One more celebration of a special week in making and showing art. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in the San Francisco Bay Area.